child. It's it's that time of the week. It's a Friday, babe. I can't help myself. I was trying to find ways of making the Friday sound without having to use that much energy, but hey, it's Friday. The energy just kind of like comes out. Anywho, Bananga, thank you for keeping it with me that whole week. Ooh, child. Mm-mm. Well, let's delve into things that I do understand. My name is Tina Fierce-One and welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Anywho, given it's a Friday, you get yourself a copy of the Kampala Sad. In case you haven't yet gotten yourself one by now, get yourself a copy. Hey. And of course, they are saying, the Kampala Sad nange walio buenje davida. Remember, why do we have so many young millennials useless sometimes? Because I mean, look at the people they have on their pages, the front page. We have MC Katz and Fie, Sheila Gashumba and God's Plan, something about dancing, and then I think the eldest here, SK Mbuga and Vivian, and I don't even think they're that old. I'm just saying. Anywho, they are saying Sheila's lover opens up now in an exclusive interview. Yes, in an exclusive call interview. God's Plan was there telling the reporter how him and Sheila are good regardless of all your negative vibes. They have something strong, something real. They're going to be taking this to the whole next level in case y'all don't even know, and they won't even be seeking your acceptance of them. They moved into a house in Kololo, but I am wondering, I thought anyway, he's saying he loves her just as much as she loves him. She's saying, leave us alone. And I'm wondering, just by show of hands, who is really bothered that Sheila and God's Plan are together? Willis, are you bothered? Does it help with youth unemployment in any way? Does it? Jonah, are you bothered? Does it help with Chirudu's sewage system? Farouk? What do you have to say? Does it help with the fact that we are broke on a Friday? Now let us go in front to get a mass. Anyway, they are talking about that. But the story that actually made me get the Kampala Sun today that I wanted to delve in, but not that I got it from there. So I know most of you are still wondering, so what's SK Mbuga's situation? What is Vivian's situation? Now, the latest I heard is, yes, they are both incarcerated. Yes, they have way too much debt. They cannot afford to pay off all the debt that they have incurred. But here's the sweet part. They are going to file for bankruptcy. And the type that they can easily sign up for is to liquidate all assets. That's why they had already started to liquidate pretty much everything, like I told you. Not these things that family was claiming, Vivian had to first chase all her in-laws out of her marital home. I'm like, wait, what's going down? I want to know, at what point SK Mbuga and Vivian didn't think that there was going to have to be time for this? At what point webali bakuba deal wezo ezezo sente tebachiro wozako mbajja kutusiba? At what point didn't they think about that after the lavish lifestyle we're going to do, the wedding and spending and all these things, we're going to raise some red flags? I don't know. There's something like very, very freaky here, because first he agrees to do the time, right? He agrees to it. Vivian does not even try to run from the law. She is taken at will properly. She's in. Now, when they're in after liquidating enough assets to pay off the Dubai prison, they move him to a much more comfortable facility. And he's like, yeah, it's cool, I'll do the time. But as I'm doing the time, I need for you to understand that I don't have the kind of money that I took from you. So what happens next? You file for bankruptcy. When you file for bankruptcy, they're going to liquidate your assets and try to pay back as many of the debts as you have. So he's liquidating all his assets. That's in a bid to make them understand that, yo, mulabenze nkazi, I'm going to liquidate all my assets, try to pay off as many debtors as I can, and where I fail, I'm just going to file for bankruptcy, and there's nothing you can do about that. I'm like, wait, that's well planned. So even if he liquidated all his assets, never managed to pay all his creditors, he could still come back to court and say, I'm filing for bankruptcy, I can't pay all these people, I don't have this money. That seems like a good plan. And then he'll probably take a hiatus off of 2019 and show face again in 2021 or 2020. It's a good plan, people. I feel like it's a good plan. And then when he comes back, it's going to be on the reserve money that he had. Oh, well. Ah, playing with fire. Kati nogena notunulira bana abato ababiyingira myo. You people kamba bulire chibete chala. I used to think those things were just words we used to say, but it's the truth. It's the truth. And what's sad and what's disheartening and what's sickening for me is the fact that, man, after we see these guys go down like this, there's a bunch of stupid boys out there who are still saying, wow, nzezo diru nenzi guamo buladi nziyisawo, nziyisawo. And they forget there's always this part. This part, and this part is the hardest. Tokuziri anokuzi sasanya sibuzibu. Kati, ninze basibe don nasa. Tulikuchi sofa kwa woyu. Tebana msako msango. Che you not ever muted dechi. But I am tired of having an educated rich men in Kampala who do not know how to be smart. Nzebona, even if you don't have an education, please nyambobe dene street smart. Like, we expect these guys to be that street smart, but they're out here acting like dumb blondes and bimbos wearing pink tutus, and yet they are men. I'm tired. What happened to the breed of men that our fathers were? Like, you remember back in the day you'd hear that odd story where they'll be like, oh, yo, tata we yali akolera mu government. Baba sente. Guno gwaka. Tetumanyi tata we jali, na yetumala baba lina sente. You get what I'm saying? Remember those stories? Like, they were smart enough to know this is a do or die, not in chikubia kumandi. Katite, you never mkwati demu guno. Agenda kumala we miezi mkaga ba mulete diru endala na yaji kubi. What is this nonsense? Have them deported. Can't we sell them? Can a country sell a citizen? Netugamba, we as Ugandans would like to sell to you all these idiots who are in South Africa and all these idiots are Abafiri. Just thinking about it. Now, when Uganda Temweva say, at times I wonder when Ugandans will actually have empathetic and sympathetic hearts. But you just don't. Now, yesterday, after the whole Gravity Omutuju story broke, I was also concerned. I tried reaching out to him and nothing happened. I couldn't get through. But after a while, like after we saw this, we first saw the story, all of us got alarmed. We started reporting about it, talking about it. But by yesterday evening, it had turned into a hashtag, the Gravity Challenge. Because, like I mentioned yesterday, Binebi wundu biya gravity, ngabidi somewhat different. Now, we are waiting for him to come and give us an explanation, but at this rate, masasika gravity gandifana nange nyondo za Chris Evans, ngabwe mbidaba walai, nyondo za Chris Evans zali munana. Yagamba he blacked out kuyoku satu. Kati agono guy. Kwa waku yoti ya chifanani. You have a bullet wound here. And a bullet wound here. And then you have a moment to lean back. Minutes after it has just been happened. It has just done. Like, yo. Bandage. 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 Kona bandage. Na goes. No. It was plasters. Like, plasters, yo. I was like, what first aid wound is that? Is it a run through wound? Did it stay lodged in there? Then that drop of blood wouldn't be small. Then someone gave me a different theory. Nagamba, no. It seems that the askari who shot at him had a bayonet on his on his gun. Now all of you don't know what a bayonet is. That kind of thing in World War II or any rifle that where you can put a gun and when you get into close combat with your enemy, you can stab them. So yagambi neda mundu chayaba deko chovola, but he has with two stab wounds, tweet, tweet, on the stomach. Another one was like, wait, we took another photo and the move, the wound has moved. It was here, now it is here. I cannot with you, Ugandan. Someone could be out there fighting for their life and you're out here making jokes. If you ask me, what's my theory? I personally think, this is what I'm, and this is my final thought on it. I think it was overly dramatized. I think it was overly dramatized. I think, yes, he did get some wounds from the entire scuffle and all of that. We are happy that he did not lose his life because this has been happening. You know? But he's okay. I think it was overly dramatized. I don't think he was that much injured, though he was injured because... So I don't know, who should we blame? Should we blame the people who gave us the report, Mbubamu Kubia Masasi Manji, or should we blame Gravity himself? And I'm not talking about Gravity. given this stuff happened in Honorable Zake's constituency, he was all up about and hey, now there's the ambulance, I'm like, Honorable Member of Parliament, send you. But you have to be honest though. I hate how our parliamentarians use these opportune moments just to say, just to go back on their political banter. Like if you have come to be my Member of Parliament, be my Member of Parliament, Zake was out there saying some things, isn't it? I mean, we're all condoning gun violence. We're sick and tired of gun violence. I'm tired of how these people, power people, just jump on everything. Barag, Gasinama Basimul on this beautiful Friday. Did y'all know that Pastor Martin Semper? Yes, the guy who has two accents. This guy is amazing. Like the times when you see Semper, like do something and he's in this tune like, yo, people need to understand, like what you don't get about the fake religion is something like it's so much bigger, it's extraterrestrial. Then when you catch him on our way, as he's like, Neda, you need to understand that the things of the faith, then you're like, wait, am I dealing with God? Oh God, which one is it? Hey, he changed his name from Pastor Martin Tempa, he's now Pastor Baba Ad. For all of you who know what time it is, wait for the YouTube upload in case you're just watching us on YouTube. But for all of you who are going to be at home, Saloon Talk this Sunday is going to be fire. Guess who we had him sit down with? Now, we got good versus evil. We got Pastor Baba, a.k.a. Martin Semper, and we got none other than the loudmouth. You people think I'm a loudmouth? Oriyo Guguwebambi. Woo! Woo! Full figure! And she has blue hair. I don't even know who told her that. That hair, it was hideous. Hideous. But anyway, what Saloon Talk on Sunday? They are so getting into it. I watched the promo and I was like, yes, I want this. Other than that, it's been swell chilling with you during this week. I do hope next week brings us more juicier gossip. I wish we could throw more shade lately because there's no shade to throw. I hate it. I hate it when there's no shade to throw, because when there's no shade to throw, then I'm going to get petty. And when I'm petty, I turn out to be ratchet. When I'm ratchet, I'm not your best situation when I'm ratchet. So, yeah, I do hope that comes next week. We get some stuff that's good. Other than that, don't drink and drive, people. Don't do dare drink and drive. Always wear protection. That's if it's necessary. You know what I mean? If you trust a person, no one should be trusted in this day and age. That, just to be honest. I'm out. I'll catch you again Monday. Peace.